Previously on Dream Team.
Well, with my starstruck, I want to play games with my fitness coach. Your relationship is supposed to be professional.
It is.
Liam Mackay, crew have agreed to let him go for $500,000. You give me 10 grand a week, and it never leaves this room. Otherwise, you can kiss your Rose brothers goodbye.
Eugene Rose, I'm arresting you on suspicion of aggravated burglary.
Well, someone's going to prison, Miss Tyler. Either it's him or you.
I wouldn't have even been in this position if you hadn't have told them what you did.
This donut thinks he's better than me. He's dreaming. I ain't going down. I ain't even guilty. I'm staying right here.
I can't begin to tell you how much trouble you're in.
Harchester still 1-0 down at the Lair. Kasper Rose, now is he caught by Ehiog? No free kick. Still plenty of home pressure here. Again, Kasper Rose tries his luck, but the frustration level's growing for the striker. Still looking for that elusive equaliser. Kasper Rose and Schwarzer down to make the save. 5 minutes left. The Rose brothers can't seem to play with each other or without. Kasper off, Eugene on. Eugene Rose, and that is tame. It won't extend. Mark Schwarzer and a very uneasy feeling on that Harchester United bench. Time is rapidly running out here for Harchester. Poor old Linda Block, back as chief executive, would have hoped for so much better here today. But it's a third successive Premiership defeat. The momentum has long gone from that opening weekend win against Liverpool. Mark Viduka's goal separates them here. Harchester lose 1-0.
Felix.
Just a moment, Ashley.
Hey, you even gonna try?
You're dissing me! You're supposed to be running with it, man. Taking people on.
Yes, Ashley?
The Rose brothers are making a laughingstock of us.
Not now. What is it?
Is it okay if I shoot straight on, Gaffer? The missus has got a meeting with a lawyer.
Yeah.
But if they want to behave like children, then let's treat them that way.
I said not now.
In fact, let's drop them both. Sticking Moody or Jackson, I know that they're youth team, but they can't do any worse.
Then I want your opinion. I will ask for it!
Hey!
Sorry.
Ashley King?
Yeah?
I probably have the advantage of you. I read the article in 442. A lady fitness coach at a Premiership club. Very impressive.
Thank you. Mr...
Dempsey.
But if you're not club personnel, you probably shouldn't be here on match day.
I'm waiting to see your boss and Mrs. Block. I've got an interview. I thought I'd take a look around.
You're a reporter?
God, no. I'm here about the job as first team coach.
This is football. One cannot predict such things. Now, if you don't have any more questions...
I have a question for you.
Ashley, this is an interview. Ashley King, our director of fitness.
What are you doing, hiring someone else to do my job?
Pardon?
Well, Alex Dempsey's through there waiting for his interview.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Look, you know for a fact that France thing was not my fault. This is not how I expect things to be done around here. But hey, there's a woman around. Let's blame her. That's football for you.
You made an absolute fool out of me.
She made a laughingstock of the whole club. What were you thinking, Ashley?
Well, I'm sorry, but if a man turns up with a letter inviting him to an interview, I'll assume he's telling the truth.
He doesn't have a letter.
Yes, he does. Sent by you.
Excuse me? Mr. Dempsey, sorry to keep you waiting. It's been a difficult day.
Well, your girl's been keeping well supplied.
Well, Amy doesn't normally make me appointments on match days. Do you have a letter?
Yeah.
May I?
Yeah. And this is my CV.
Thank you. Would you mind if I just get you one moment longer? Amy, boardroom now.
Mm.
you type this?
Why? What's wrong?
Pen. That's my signature. And so is that.
Yes.
Yes, except I didn't write this one. I've never seen this letter before in my life. I did not invite this man here. Do you understand?
Then how did he get it?
My God. Of course.
What?
Well, this is just the kind of infantile joke he'd enjoy.
He certainly follows your career, doesn't he?
You think he might be a... what's the word?
Stalker.
You think he forged the letter himself?
Amy, get rid of him.
Mr. Dempsey, I'm really sorry. There seems to be some sort of mix-up. Felix and Linda can't see you now. They're, in a meeting.
I see.
Well, why don't you leave your numbers with me and I'll call you to rearrange?
Playing directions here, and what does that mean?
Right, it's all over in 10 minutes, usually. They read out the charge against you, you enter your plea.
Guilty.
Not guilty.
We've been over this.
Yes, we have.
Then they set a trial date, probably around 3 months' time, and discuss bail. Given your circumstances, they'll ask for a substantial sum. 100,000, possibly more.
That's half the commission she got for taking Eugene Rose to Harchester. And this is his fault. He should pay.
I have to take this. Please excuse me.
Chloe, call him back.
Peter, hi. That boy, thank you. I'm going to the market.
Every time I go to talk about this, she takes another call.
Look, I know this must be a difficult time for you both, but she needs your support.
She won't let me. It's all about how much money she can make in case she goes down. I've got money. I'm a Premiership footballer, for God's sake.
And you can't get her to change her plea?
She won't have it. If she pleads guilty, our precious client goes down. And we can't have that.
Sorry. Where were we?
Four! Miss King. What a pleasant surprise. Care for a round of golf?
This time you've gone too far.
What? Don't you like the outfit?
You duped some poor ex-pro into thinking he's going to get my job. Forged Linda Block's signature on a letter. And caused me to make a complete fool out of myself at a post-match press conference.
Yeah, I saw that. However, this time I'm going to have to plead not guilty.
Pardon?
It's not my style. And anyway, I have no interest in screwing up your job. I said I was sorry about the France thing. I meant it.
I don't believe you.
Believe what you want. Five, four,
oi!
Three.
Are you dizzy, Blunt? I'm gonna bang you up, Chief!
James, stop!
Oh, come on, Eugene. Just a little bit further.
Are you seriously firing golf balls at his house to make him break his curfew? How often's he been doing this?
Every night this week.
Evening, Scarlet.
He don't look at you. He don't speak to you. Inside!
Eugene! Scarlet, let me deal with this.
I'm going to report this to Felix. You know as well as I do, that tag's in place for a prison sentence. If he breaks his curfew, he could go to jail. You want to know why I think you're out here, spending your evenings trying to get your brother into trouble? Because you don't believe that you can beat him fair and square on the pitch. You think he'll score more goals than you. And for once, I think you're right.
It's your first offence, and you did it for a client. If you get anything, you'll just be painting old ladies' fences.
I lose my license if I get done for this.
It's not like we'll starve. I'm on premiership money. All I need to do is get in the team. And by the way, what exactly did the manager say when he signed me?
What do you mean?
Well, it's like he was in that much of a rush to sign me. And now he can't even be bothered to say two words to me. It's like he's forgotten I'm there. So come on. What did he say? What does he want from me?
I can't talk about this now.
Why not? Where are you going?
I can't sleep. I'm just going to go downstairs and watch some TV. I don't want to disturb you.
I can watch some TV.
No. I just want to be on my own. Edinee, vodka and tonic, please. Actually, make it a double.
Mrs. Block.
Mr. Dempsey.
Don't call us, we won't call you, eh?
Pardon?
That girl isn't going to rearrange the meeting, is she?
You know what, I think there seems to be some misunderstanding. We're actually fully staffed. No, if you'll excuse me.
Wait!
I had to travel halfway across the country. If you were fully staffed, why did you send me a letter inviting me to an interview?
You know we didn't write that letter.
What?
Let go of me.
You think I faked that letter? Mrs. Block, you know me. We met once years ago when I played for Sheffield Wednesday. I'm not some nutter.
I had an injury a couple of years ago. Did my cruciate. Finished my playing career. 30 years old and I didn't know anything about anything except football.
Must have been tough.
I had my coaching badges to keep me going. You got to, don't you? For your kids, if nothing else.
I know how that feels.
I know you do. I thought that might be why you wrote to me. Trying to help someone like yourself. Oh, how could you have known it was my dream job to work with Felix? What?
Did you forge my signature?
What?
I won't be angry. I mean, if nothing else, it shows good initiative. It's just that I know I didn't write it.
Why would I turn up with a letter you'd bound to know I'd forged? And how am I going to expect to get a job behaving like that? Look, did I do that myself or not? If you didn't write it, and I didn't, what's going on?
Amy, this is the letter that I was sent offering me this job from our mysterious owners. Now, every now and again, I get instructions. Always in the same envelope, same ink, same writing. Alex Dempsey, the man who was here yesterday, he had the same envelope. Now, that was a cruel trick they played, inviting him here to apply for his dream job when there was no vacancy. Now, I want to track them down to make sure they don't pull another stunt like that. Do you know where the letters come from?
No.
But you sort out my post.
Just what's in your tray.
Yeah, but how did it get there? I mean, there's no stamp on it. It must be hand-delivered.
Well, there's the internal post, couriers, secretaries dropping by memos.
Amy, you're telling me that you've never seen one of these envelopes be delivered? Right. Well, can you make sure you look out for it in future?
Of course. I thought you might like to see this morning's papers.
What? Unacceptable. I didn't come back to this club to have it dragged through the press, especially by the management.
If you're going to accuse a club of sexism, I suggest you find out who your chief executive is beforehand.
Linda, I don't think she meant for this.
And I suggest you concentrate on the next game. You know, 3 defeats in a row is enough to jeopardise anyone's job. Now, I've called Alex Dempsey. I'm offering him a month's trial, effective immediately.
You can't do that.
I just have. I've also arranged for the press to come down here. They're going to take a couple of pictures, some nice interviews, and we're going to get back into the press for football reasons. Not this.
The whole situation is entirely my fault. What can I say? I don't like losing. I was so wound up after the game that...
Do you like your staff talking to you like that?
I like my staff to care deeply about the fortunes of the team. I'm sure the supporters are glad to know we take defeats as badly as they do.
And what about Alex Dempsey? Do you intend employing him now?
The manager makes decisions that he feels are in the best interest for Harchester United. Whenever he brings somebody in, it's because they have something to offer the club.
So do you take back your comment about women in football?
That was said in the heat of the moment. Linda Block and I were just laughing about it upstairs. It's the first time she's been accused of chauvinism.
You know, it isn't easy for women in football. Is it, Ryan?
It's a hard world out there, Casper.
Seems to me that at a time like this, we need to show solidarity with our sisters.
100% commitment.
What do you think, Ash?
We're all part of the same team?
Absolutely.
I really appreciate the offer, Mrs. Block, but I don't think I can accept.
Surely you're not going to turn me down after all this.
Look, don't get me wrong, you know, I'm desperate for the job. It's just I like to earn everything I get. If this is because of the problem over the letter, then I just don't want to get the job on a technicality.
All right. A trial. 4 weeks, and if you're crap, I'll sack you.
Perfect.
Maybe you can bring some order into the dressing room.
I'll do my best.
You should have been at the training pitch an hour ago. Do we really have to supervise you every minute of the day? Training will now overrun. You know, if we don't win the next game, we're going to be on the bottom three. But then I guess you guys don't think about the consequences of...
Thank you, Ashley. I'll take it from here. Lads, this is Alex Dempsey. He's joining us as first team coach.
You all right, boss?
All right.
Dempsey, why don't you take the team inside?
After you, lads. I should have said ladies.
I thought we are going to put on a nice show for the media. But they got a feminist rally.
Are you seriously blaming me for that?
Do you perhaps think what would have happened if you'd taken it as a joke?
Casper is doing it to get at me.
It's always about Casper, isn't it? You're uptight around him.
Maybe because he keeps undermining me and you refuse to discipline him.
Go home, Ashley.
What?
Your emotions are not useful to me.
What's this?
I don't know. What does it say?
It's a contract of employment for Alex Dempsey. That's impossible. I've only just agreed terms with him now. How can... Who gave you this?
I don't know. It was just in your mail. I presume the legal department. Have I done something wrong? Mrs. Block?
Shred it.
Hello, Linda. Please leave a message.
Yes, it's me. Pick up the phone. Pick up the phone.
Okay, then just sit there and listen. If you don't think I'm capable of doing my job, why did you bother bringing me back here in the first place? I will not be spied upon at work. It's an invasion of privacy. And I will not have my signature forged. In fact, if you do anything like that again, I'll report you to the police. Look, if you want to know so badly what's going on here, why don't you tell me who you are? Then I'll tell you all about it.
Quite finished early, Gaffer. I thought I'd come in. It's been a while.
You two know each other?
We used to.
You can sit this one out, Liam. What are you thinking?
Oh, it's nothing, Gaffer.
Come on, if you are here, you might as well contribute.
At PSV, you play 4-3-3. You've always played with either two up or three up with two wide. You like to occupy defences.
Successfully.
So? Well, why just the one striker? I mean, I know you've had your problem with the Rose brothers, but...
If you are building something, you have to do it from the back. The team must learn to be compact before they can play with freedom. I'll take some criticism, but that's okay.
The team must come first.
I thought you could maybe try five across the back, Gaffer. Use your wing backs to give you a wee bit.
Okay. Ryan, tights off.
Rossi, Carter, on.
Every day I love you less and less. It's clear to see that you've become obsessed.
Gaffer, any chance of a walk?
I've got a lot on right now. Why don't you talk to Dempsey?
Really, I wanted to talk to you. Hardly spoken since I joined the club. Wanted to know how you saw me. How you think I'm going to fit in. Well, can you tell me if I'm in your plans for Saturday?
No, you're not.
Was there anything I should be working on, you know, to put myself in your plans?
You're doing just fine.
Holding those skirts against me. I thought we looked quite good together. Hey?
Have you completely lost your mind?
Actually, I think I've just found it.
Well, you want to injure me? You could have put me out of football.
Well, if that's what your career is based on, it explains a lot. Anyway, now you know how it feels. You've been trying to ruin my career since the day you got here.
You seriously did this because you can't take a joke. You know? You should really see someone about your mental health.
Why can't you just leave me alone?
Love to.
But no, you have to see me suffer.
See you suffer?
And all because your pathetic little ego can't accept the fact that we didn't sleep together. You just keep rubbing it in.
You know, I've been warned about people like you. Crazy fans have become obsessed. You dream about me too, don't you? It's all right, Ash, you can admit it. You can tell me. There's no shame in it. God, you can tell me!
Yeah? Do you really want me to shred this? I mean, if you've given Mr. Dempsey a job, he's gonna need a contract. No, Amy, you're right. I just don't like this feeling I'm being spied on, that's all. It's manipulation. Why appoint me as chief executive if they're going to hire people over my head? Amy, I'm sorry I took it out on you.
So I'm okay to send this out?
Mm-hmm.
I just wish I knew who they were, you know? At least we could talk then, face to face. Why the hell does it have to be a secret, anyway?
I'll call you back. What's wrong?
I'm not in the team again. I tried to talk to the manager. Nothing. He won't use me in training. He won't even look at me. And guess what? He's brought in Alex Dempsey.
When? Do you think he knows?
You're asking me questions. Why don't you ask them?
What do you mean?
Get me a meeting with Han and Linda Block, and we'll sort this out once and for all. I will not be ignored.
I don't think that's such a good idea.
Why not? Because I'm not your precious Eugene Rose.
Of course not.
Then get on the phone and call him. Stop moping about your bloody court case and do something for me. Because in 3 months' time, I'm going to be the only breadwinner this family's got.
How dare you? If you hadn't have opened your mouth to the police, we wouldn't be in this trouble.
No. If you hadn't lied to the police, we wouldn't be in this trouble. Maybe it's a good thing you lose your job. Because where I'm standing, you're not very good at it.
This is a nice surprise.
I just wanted to come up and say thank you in person for everything you did.
I'm only doing my job.
Well, maybe. But there's no way I'd be here without you. I won't forget that.
I'm sure you'll do really well.
What's so urgent exactly? You don't call me in weeks and then you want me here at the drop of a hat. I had a hair appointment. So, what do you fancy? Curry? Chinese?
Whatever you want.
Well, I'm having a korma and plain rice. I'm not eating bread this month.
Remember that party you had in the summer? There was a girl there in an orange dress, blonde wig. Fell in the pool.
And?
Do you know who she was?
The one who was really off her head?
Yeah, that's the one.
No idea. I think she was a gate crasher. Why?
Lost my watch. Was trying to track down who might have taken it.
I don't know, Cass.
Yeah, someone must. Who bought her? You don't just stumble onto a party like yours.
I don't know her.
Yeah, well, I can buy 50 new watches if I want.
I should be going.
Oh, wait. You said you were going to stay for dinner.
Paul will miss me. It's late.
Babe. Look. Why didn't you come to the game on Saturday?
I don't know.
We can go out afterwards. I'm always up for going out afterwards. I'll get you comps. Come on, babe. I'll see you Saturday.
Saturday. You treat me like some boot boy and now you're all matey with this guy who's just rolling off the street.
I shouldn't have shouted at you. It was wrong of me, I apologize. You know what I'm like when we are losing matches. It affects both of us. But you must admit, you haven't been your normal self.
I know.
It's because of Casper.
No, I told you there's nothing going on.
Ashley, he clearly feels there is.
I don't care what he thinks. I'm with you, aren't I? It's not the same as it was when we were at PSV. Everything I've done in football, I've had your support, and I need to know that I still have that. Do you still rate me?
Of course I do. You are my right-hand girl. I cannot manage without you.
The return to the Premiership was filled with such hope. But as Harchester United now prepare to welcome in-form Manchester City, the Dragons fans will be hoping for a complete turnaround. It's been a disastrous week of PR, and that run of poor form that leaves Harchester United 16th in the table. The pressure is on manager Felix Hahn, but he is still hamstrung by the fact that he can't field the Rose brothers together from the start. He can only hope that he finds now the recipe for success.
Some chance.
I'm not really up to this.
We're not hiding away. We've done nothing wrong.
Why are you so dressed up?
Because I want people to see we're not ashamed. Not of anything. And you are going to look great in this.
A bit over the top, isn't it?
It's my favourite. You were wearing it the first time we met.
Okay, just for you.
Babe, will you do me a favour? My comps have to go down to reception. Can you put them in an envelope for me, name of Annabelle Davis?
I think your guests have already arrived.
Don't worry about it. You can deliver them yourself.
I'm sorry?
You're not playing today, Casper.
You'll be entertaining your guests personally.
You're joking, yeah?
No. You are the joker here. It's clear after the week we've had that you are more interested in playing games than playing football. And until that changes, you won't be a part of my plans.
Miss Amy Kerrigan.
Mrs. Block. Mrs. Block. The sponsors are here. You need to be heading through.
Good news. I'm not playing today, so you get me all to yourself.
Cass, you remember my husband, Paul?
Cass! Great to see you again. And I can't say I'm sorry you're up here with us rather than doing your stuff out there on the pitch.
I said if he insisted on coming, he should at least pretend to support the home team.
By the way, my solicitor's still waiting to hear from you. About the house. Only we found somewhere we want to move to, so I'm hoping to push this on.
Darling, do you mind?
Can I open my eyes now?
Yeah.
What's going on?
Marry me.
But we're already engaged.
Marry me now.
But we're getting married in 4 months. It's already arranged.
I don't want to wait. Because whatever happens, I won't... You make me so happy. And I just want to tell you that...
It's okay. Just have.
Off the pitch events have really overshadowed this Harchester United Premiership season so far. Is there better things to come today against Manchester City? Stuart Pearce has got his side really galvanised and they're on the attack early on here. It's Andy Cole, it's Darius Vassell, and it's a decent ball in as well, and that was close Danny Sullivan getting an important foot in there for Harchester. And a significant change on the bench today. This is Alex Dempsey, who's got a hands-on role today alongside Felix Hahn. No sign of Ashley King. Is this a sign of a change of regime for Harchester? Decent ball in, Andy Cole's header off the underside of the bar.
Come on. Of course you can. Tell him to leave the loo. Come on, listen.
Yeah, maybe you should go.
Are you sitting with us?
No, I never watch from the stands. Always get too much hassle from the fans. Safer for me in here.
All right, well, we'll stay with you if you want.
I'm waste the best seats in the house, don't be daft. Go on, I'll catch up with you half time. Go on, otherwise you might as well have stayed at home. Oh, Annabelle. Can't take that in with you. 10 minutes.
David Evans hits a terrific run. He's got to the byline and Eugene Rose squanders Harchester's
unlucky,
first
bro.
Opportunity of this match. And he knows what a good chance that was. Joey Barton now for Manchester City. It's Andy Cole. Oh, and Darius Vassell's in here. Alex O'Meara to meet him, but there's Barton to score the opening goal at the Dragon's Lair. Alex O'Meara, the Harchester goalkeeper, did all he could there, but they are one down. Close to half-time, and Stuart Pearce's Manchester City have been comfortably on top in this first half. And here comes Danny Mills. Look at the space he's got to run into that Harchester United half. Still it's Mills. He might go for goal here. And it's deflected away off Jody Carter. The last action of a very poor Harchester opening 45 minutes. The body language of manager Felix Hahn tells the sorry tale here.
Linda, what are you doing? Are you going through my bag?
Yes, look, I know this must look really weird, but it's not what you think, honestly. I mean, I know what it looks like.
That card, it's personal.
Amy, about the card and the flowers, are they from...
David, it's my boyfriend. Look, we'd had a row. I'm sorry, but it's really none of
it. No, I'm terribly, terribly sorry. What I've just done is unforgivable. Please don't think I'm like this, because I'm not. Okay? It'll never happen again. Sorry.
Painted on? What is this made of?
Oh, it's Paul. Maybe I should answer it.
Or maybe not.
Yes. Now, if you don't take that dress off.
Eugene Rose still bemoaning the lack of service. There isn't a great deal of movement on the Harchester bench either.
Hardly the medallions of lamb and a bit of parmesan de foie in time for the reception.
The crap.
Ball in midfield now, and Barton challenging here with Danny Sullivan.
Stop him, Naismith.
Pick up the pieces in midfield here, Manchester City. Ryan Naismith.
Wasted. There's no way I'm worse than that. I should be there.
In comes a useful looking cross, and Andy Cole's on the end of this. Oh, and he scored.
What are you playing at?
To worse for Harchester United. Andy Cole who went so.
Chloe?
I don't mind being a football widow for the next 50 years, but not on my wedding night. Now, where do you want your marmite?
Events off the field still having plenty of effect on it, sadly, for Harchester. Just seconds left here, and Manchester City may be in the mood to help themselves to a third here. It's Joey Barton! Desperately close. It's the last action of what, frankly, has been a woeful display by Harchester. Andy Cole ran their defence ragged. The many problems need to be addressed, and quickly.
I've nothing to say to anyone.
That's right, Andy. We won't be hearing from Felix Hahn after he apparently left the stadium without talking to his team. That would certainly suggest he's far from happy with their performance today.
Yes.
It's not very nice. Not when I've come to return a piece of your property. Look what I found.
Move your foot or I'll call...
Well, security. Go ahead. I've said what I need to by the time they get here. This is the dress you weren't wearing the night you didn't meet me at that party, isn't it?
I've never seen it before.
When are you going to stop lying?
I'm not. It's not mine. Wouldn't wear anything so cheap like some slapper.
Do you know where this came from?
I don't care.
Annabelle. Remember her? She doesn't know how it got into her house, but we do, don't we? What's the matter? Run out of excuses?
No.
Look, you can pretend what you like. Pretend we didn't sleep together that night, whatever. Doesn't matter. Because this proves we did. I know it. So do you.
Well?
I don't remember.
Don't lie to me! This cheap dress, as you refer to it, cost 1,500 euros. You know how I know? Because I paid for it!
I know.
You remember? Sorry, I don't understand. You told him you'd never seen it before. You slept with him, didn't you? And all that's gone on over the last weeks. It's all been about trying to cover it up, hasn't it? Hasn't it? You were right about one thing. This dress does belong to... What was the word? Slapper.
Gaffer?
Not now.
5 minutes, it's all I need.
I said not now.
I've had it, we not now. That's all you ever say to me.
I might not be one of your famous Rose Brothers, but I deserve your respect too. I'm a member of your squad.
Please, can we do this on Monday morning?
No, not Monday, now. I'm fed up of being ignored. All I want to know is, Why would you sign me if you can't even be bothered to talk to me?
Why don't you ask your wife?
I have. Why would she know? Hey!
Get your hands off me.
Not you tell me what's going on.
You want to know? Fine. I never signed you. I never wanted you. You are a lower division journeyman. But your wife had us over a barrel. If we wanted Eugene in time for the Liverpool game, we had to take you. So we did. Does that answer your question?
Coming up on Dream Team.
Is that it? You're divorcing me after 6 hours of marriage?
I think we've got a great setup here. What do you think?
On Tuesday, we will have a training match. And if this boy performs better in that match than this man, he will take his place on Saturday.
Yes! Get in!
You can't end things over this.
Seeing as you know all about it, what is it exactly that we're supposed to have done?